Welcome students to my channel GK's Education. In this video today we are going to discuss accounts of not-for-profit organization. As we know, there are always two types of works. One, either we are working for profit making or we are providing a service to the society, that we can say not for profit concern. In the profit making concerns, either we are manufacturing an item, then we trade it or sell in the market. Here, if we are manufacturing an item, we make manufacturing account and then trading account. After that, profit and loss account, and at last balance sheet. But in the trading concerns, we don't make the manufacturing account. Here only the trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet are prepared. But again, there are also some concerns which do not work for making a profit, that is the not-for-profit making concerns. Here we can say it is an organization which is made for the welfare of society and are set up as charitable institutions, means they provide a service to the society. They provide they do the acts which are somewhere for the upliftment of society. We can say that these organizations do not manufacture, purchase or sell goods. They may not have credit transactions, so they need not to maintain the trading and profit and loss accounts. But even then, they have to keep the record of what the funds are coming in, how the money is coming in and how they are spending it out, whether they are able to make their expenses by themselves or not. So they keep the records in various accounts which are known as receipt and payment account, income and expenditure account and balance sheet. Receipt and payment account, it is the first account which they maintain. It is an account we can say same as the cash book. That means it is a real account. Debit, what comes in, and credit, what goes account. In this account, they enter all the monetary receipts, whether they are from bank or they are in cash, and they also record all the payments, which whether they are from the bank or they are in cash. So this account, we can say, records all the transactions in the particular period, whether they are related to that period or not. That means even if they are receiving the subscriptions for the coming years, even then they enter them into the receipt account. If they are making the payments in advance for coming years, even then they will record them in the payment account. Here let us see the basic performer of receipt and payment account. It is a basic performer. We can see the debit side is the receipt side. That means debit, what comes in, and the credit side is the payment side. That means credit, what goes out. The basic rule of a real account. Here we can see, just write receipt and payment account for the year ending, whatever the period you are recording. Like the first thing we go to enter is the balance brought down, means the last year's, the previous year's closing balance of cash as well as bank will be the opening balance this year in our book. Then we are having the transactions of subscriptions. Subscription means the members of our organization. The organizations can be, we can say, educational institutions, we can say clubs, sports clubs, senior citizens clubs, all type of service providing societies. So subscriptions is an income for us. When people become the member of our organization, they pay some type of you can say a fee to us, which is an income. These subscriptions may be for the present year, may be for the coming years in advance, or maybe for the previous years if anything is left. All of them will be entered on the debit side of receipt and payment account. Then comes the general donations, means in our non-profit making organizations, we can receive donations. So these will be our income and will be entered on the debit side. Again, next is sale of old newspapers, waste papers, and periodicals. That means if we are selling the old things, the proceeds will be entered on the debit side, so as we are getting the money. Next is sale of old sports material, means the old things which are worn off, we can say we are not able to use them now. They'll be the proceeds from the sale will be entered in the debit side. Next come interest on the fixed deposits. As we can say, these organizations may have some spare money which they can deposit in bank or some other organizations to earn some interest, or to not to keep the money idle. So the interest received from these type of deposits will be our income and will be entered on the debit side. Next is locker rent. Like if we are running a sports club, there we will have the lockers where the incomers will be keeping their things or their belongings. So we can, if we are charging rent from them for the lockers, that will be our income and will be entered on the debit side. Next is sale of scraps. Anything which is not usable and is sold out, the proceeds will be entered here. Again comes the proceeds from the charitable shows. Like if we are having a charitable institutions, definitely we'll be working to raise funds. We can organize shows, we can organize exhibitions, and all the incomes from those will be entered on the debit side. Next is miscellaneous receipts, means all other type of receipts will be entered here. Next is grant in aid, means like if we are running an organization or an NGO where we get a particular grant from the government or any other institution, so that will be entered here. Next is legacies, specific donations. All type of donations for any specific purpose will be entered here. Next is sale of investments. If we are having some type of investments in shares or anything else, so when we sell them, the incoming of money will be entered here. Sale of fixed assets. Fixed assets means like if we are having the fixed assets which are of no use now, so if we are selling them, the incoming of money will be here. Life membership fees. Some of our members can pay life full, you can say lifetime membership, which is an income for us, or which we here we are getting a money, so it will be entered here. Entrance fee, like if we organize any type of exhibition or you can say any charitable, we can say any type of show where we have some entrance fee, so that will also be entered here. The next item we can enter is receipts for specific purpose funds. Like if some, in some cases, if our state is having a having floods, so if we are receiving the donations particularly for flood victims, so they will be also be entered here. Investments. We can also, you can say, offer a type of investments where we can give interest to people. So if the people are investing in our investment options, then again the incoming of money will be there, which we will enter here. So all these are the receipts side items. Okay, and then comes the payment side. Here we can enter all the payments made, whether they are related to this year or they are related to the coming years. When the money goes out, definitely it will be entered here in our payment side. So we can see the first item here is balance brought down. In case of previous year, we were having you can say lack of balance or bank overdraft, so first it will be entered on the credit side. Then all our expenses, means the wages and salaries. Wages and salaries, whether they are related to this year or to the previous year, all will be entered as the cash is going out. Then rent. If we are running our institution in a rented accommodation, then the rent is our payment, and we enter here. Rates and taxes, insurance. If we are getting our things or our institution insured, the insurance expenses will be entered on the payment side. Printing and stationery, postage and courier, advertisement, sundry expenses, telephone charges, entertainment expenses. Like these days we are having our you can say we are having our Dish TV connections or all the things. So if we are paying the entertainment expenses, they'll be entered here. Audit fee. Audit fee means the expenditure which we pay for getting our accounts checked. So they'll be entered. Honorarium. Repair and renewals. Upkeep of grounds. Like if our institution is maintaining the grounds for golf, for cricket, for the members, so the expenses for the upkeep will be mentioned here. Conveyance charges, newspaper and periodicals, if we are arranging them for our members, so they will be entered here. Purchase of an asset, like if we are purchasing an asset, we are making a payment, the cash is going out, so that will be entered here. Purchase of investments. Any type of payment that we make during the particular year will be entered here, and the balance will be cash in hand. If the cash in hand is given, then the difference between the debit and credit side total will be cash at bank. So it is a basic performer of our receipt and payment account. Now let us discuss it with a simple example. Here we are having an example of a very simple thing. Prepare a receipt and payment account of ABC Club for the year ending 31st March 2019. We are having cash in hand on April 1, 20,000 cash at bank, subscriptions for various years, donation for building, entrance fee, life membership fee, printing and stationery and all other things. So let us solve it. First thing we are having is cash in hand. Here is receipt and payment account. Cash in hand is our opening balance. So enter it like cash in hand 20,000, cash at bank 35,000, then subscriptions, all the subscriptions to for 2017-18 30,000, 2018-19 225,000, 19 and 20 10,000. All will be entered on the receipt side. Next is donation for building. Donation is our income, so enter it on the debit side. Entrance fees is our income, 23,000. Life membership fees, again our income, 20,000. Then printing and stationery, that is our expense. We are making expense, so it will be on the credit side. Again, lighting, that will be our expense on the credit side. Rates and taxes, 17,000. Telephone charges, postage and courier, again our expense. Wages and salaries, our expense. Insurance premium, again our expense. Interest on government securities, it is our income, so it will be entered here. Then locker rent, again our income, entered on the debit side. Purchase of government securities, entered on the credit side. This cash balance carried forward, cash in hand is 23,400 and the balance cash at bank will be 70,000. So both the sides will be equal. So this is how we make receipt and payment account. The other two accounts, income and expenditure and balance sheet, will be discussed in the next video. I hope you have liked everything I have explained. Thank you.